Hello and welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on the human cell cycle with the focus on mitosis. Mitosis is how somatic cells divide. It's how one parent cell divides into two cells such that each cell has the same number of chromosomes as the parent cell. The events that take place between mitotic divisions, they together constitute interphase. There's a G1 phase, the S phase, the G2 phase, and the mitotic phase. The mitotic phase itself has mitosis, which is karyokinesis, where the nucleus divides, and the chromosomes, they get distributed to the two new cells. It also has cytokinesis, where the cytoplasm divides. Now, before we look at mitosis, we're going to look at the interphase part of the cell cycle. S is the synthetic phase, M is the mitotic phase. The G1 and G2 phases, they are gap phases in between. The G1 phase is before the synthetic phase. The G2 phase is before the mitotic phase. So during the G1 phase, the cell grows. It enters the S phase where DNA gets synthesized, meaning DNA is going to get replicated during the stage. It's actually the chromosomes that replicate. Somatic cells, they have 46 chromosomes in 23 pairs. Now these are going to double from 46 to 92. These doubled chromosomes, they are called chromatids. Then the cell enters the G2 phase, which is the pre-mitotic phase. So that's the phase where it prepares to enter the mitotic phase. And the mitotic phase is where division happens. After division, the cell can enter a G0 phase. This is the resting phase. So this is the phase where it sort of exits the dividing cycle. A cell from this stage can re-enter the cycle again through the G1 phase and then go through the cycle and divide again. But if the cell stays in the G0 phase permanently, then it's called a permanent cell. This is like nerve cells, so they don't enter the cycle again. A cell that goes into the G0 phase, but when triggered, it can enter the G1 phase, go through the cycle, and divide again, that is a stable cell, like liver cells or hepatocytes. Some cells don't bother with the G0 phase. They just keep dividing. This is like cells of the skin and hair. These are called labile cells. So there are permanent, stable, and labile cells. The cycle has to progress through these stages one after the other. And what pushes the cell cycle forward? There are proteins called cyclins. There are also kinases that are dependent on cyclins. So these are cyclin-dependent kinases. And they're inactive until the cyclin binds to the CDK. And what does a kinase do? It phosphorylates. So the cyclin CDK complex, it phosphorylates proteins, and these phosphorylated proteins, they push the cell cycle forwards. There are checkpoints in the cycle. They're sort of like guards to make sure that things are going smoothly. These are between the phases of the cycle. There's a G1S checkpoint and a G2M checkpoint. During mitosis, there's another checkpoint, but I'll get to that a little later. So at the G1S checkpoint, there's a check to see whether the cell has grown, does it have enough nutrients, and most importantly, is the DNA okay? See, after this, it's going to replicate, and it's got to make sure that what's getting replicated isn't damaged DNA. If there's something wrong, it has to stop the cycle and try to repair the DNA. If that can't happen, if the DNA is too damaged, then the cell undergoes apoptosis. The second checkpoint is before the mitotic phase, the G2M checkpoint, again checking to see if the DNA that has been replicated, is that okay, or is that damaged? Is there something wrong there? So these checkpoints are points where the cycle has to sort of stop if something goes wrong. And it's regulated by inhibitors of cyclin-dependent kinases, the CDK inhibitors, like P21, P15, P16, and things like that. They modulate the cyclin-CDK complexes and their activity. If the cell gets past all these checkpoints and the three phases of interphase, it's now ready for mitosis. So this is the cell with the nucleus and the cytoplasm. We're going to enlarge the nucleus because most of the mitosis events, they happen inside the nucleus. Now you can see that chromosome replication has already happened before mitosis even began. The cells have centrioles, that's these small cylindrical structures, which are perpendicular to each other. These are going to form the spindles. Each pair of these centrioles, along with the pericentriolar material, they together form the centrosome. Now the centrioles also divide during DNA replication in the S phase, so we have two sets of centrioles. They are going to start to move apart because of the microtubules that are growing between them, pushing them towards opposite poles. Other microtubules also form radially away from the centrioles, so it looks like a star, and these are called asters. So there are going to be two asters at either pole of the cell. The microtubules between the centrioles along with the centriole, that's called a spindle. And the whole thing together, that's both sets, they form the mitotic apparatus. Mitosis has four stages: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. There's a fifth stage that's late prophase or prometaphase between prophase and metaphase. Before prophase begins, the chromosomes have doubled, and the doubled chromosomes are called chromatids. These are sister chromatids, and they're held together by the centromere. But they're not very visible at this point. During the prophase, the chromatids, they coil and they condense, so they shorten and thicken. But they don't become visible clearly until the prometaphase, that's the late prophase. Now during this phase, the microtubules that are forming from the asters, they are going to fragment the nuclear envelope. So they're going to attach to the centromere of the sister chromatids. The point at which they attach, that is called a kinetochore. During the metaphase, the two asters, they still keep moving towards the poles of the cells. The spindles, they align the chromatids along this plane, which is at the center of the cell. This is the equatorial plate. Before anaphase, that is between metaphase and anaphase, there is an M checkpoint, or the spindle checkpoint, to see whether the chromatids are all attached to the spindle. Next, the cell moves into the anaphase. Now the chromatids are going to get pulled towards the poles, so they split at the centromere and move along the spindles. Now this is when the chromosomes get distributed between the cells. 46 chromosomes are going to go to each cell. They reach the opposite poles of the cell during the telophase. The spindles disappear. The nuclear membrane starts forming around these chromatids. Now, between the two newly forming cells, there is a contractile ring. This is from microfilaments. They form this cleavage furrow, and the cytoplasm divides. This is cytokinesis. It starts around late anaphase, but gets completed after telophase. The chromosomes are going to uncoil and lengthen and become less visible again. So now we've got two cells each with the same number of chromosomes as the parent cell. 23 pairs means diploid, so one diploid cell divided into two diploid cells. So to remember the stages of mitosis, prophase is where the chromatids condense, metaphase is when they line up along the equatorial plate, anaphase is when they start moving towards the poles, and that gets completed during telophase with the formation of the nuclear membrane. And that is the cell cycle and mitosis. If this video helped you, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.